Today we're going to learn how to create a boot screen. Now, my previous tutorial, I explained how to install the LCD, so I'm going to skip that portion and jump right into it. So in a moment, I'll show you how to set up your boot screen, and then later on I'll show you how to test it. Okay, the first thing that we want to do in order to create a boot screen is we want to open Paint. So we're going to open up Paint. And inside Paint, we need to specify the actual size of the LCD. So we're going to say resize. We're going to change it to pixels. And we're going to disable maintain aspect ratio because it's going to be horizontally 128 and vertically 64. So we're going to say OK. And then we're going to zoom in. And then we're going to come up with some kind of text. So we're going to say something like, this is my boot screen. Now you can also use pictures, but in this case, this speeds it up to demonstrate it. So then the next thing that we need to do is save it. So we're going to do save as. And we're going to select a directory. And we're going to call it boot screen. And we're going to save it as a PNG. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to close out of this. And in a moment, I'll show you on Marlin's tools page how we're going to convert it into something else. Okay, we're on the Marlin tools page. Now what we need to do is we need to import a file. So we're going to choose a file. We're going to choose boot screen. And we're going to click open. And as you can see, it says this is my boot screen from what we just created. So the next thing that we need to do at the very bottom here is, because right now it looks like it's in hex, we're going to change that to binary. It might be ASCII, but let's see what we get here. So now we have binary. So we're going to copy this. And then we're going to open up Notepad. And we're going to paste it. So in a moment, I'm going to show you how to process it into a boot screen that we can use. Okay, to create a boot screen, we need to open up the Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. Then we're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we're going to go to the source folder. Then we're going to go to the config folder. And then we're going to go to the examples folder. Now in here, we're going to open up, let's see, gcreate. And then gmax 1.5 plus. And inside here we have boot screen, so we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go up one directory, then another, and then finally one more. And we're going to paste it right here. Okay, so now we have our boot screen. We need to modify it, so we need to open it up. And inside here, we have our defined boot screen down below in binary. But the size of our screen is not 112, so we're going to change that to 128. And then we're going to go to Notepad. We're going to expand this out a little. And we're going to copy from here over all the way down to here. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go back to boot screen and we're going to do the same, but we're going to paste. So we're going to highlight all the way to here, and then paste what we just made. So we're all set here, so we're going to save it, and then we're going to close out of this and this, and we're going to open up marlin.ino in just a second. We just need to check something real quick in source. So we're going to go to source, core, then we're going to go to boards, and we're going to do a search on MKS for the MKS Gen version 1.4. So we have 1.3 here. So we're going to highlight this. So it's going to be board underscore MKS underscore Gen underscore 1.3. And that's good for both our boards. So we're going to copy this. Then we're going to close out of this. We're going to go up one directory, then another directory. Then we're going to open up the marlin.ino. Okay, now we're going to go to the configuration.h. We're going to do a search on show underscore custom. And what we want to do is it's commented out, so we need to remove the comments. Now keep in mind that if you want to do custom status screens for individual parts, it's the same process, except you probably have to make your own custom screen and then you would remove the comments. But in this case, we're going to skip that. So next we want to find motherboard. And what we want to do is we want to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 1.4 underscore EFB and paste what we copied. Then we're going to go and search on U8GLib, which is graphical library. And at this point, what we need to do is we need to be able to install this if we don't already have it installed. So the way that you would do it, I currently have it installed, but I'll show you my process when I'm online. I go to manage libraries. And then I type U8GLIB, and I scroll to the bottom, and here it is. So what you're going to do is you're going to select your version, and then this button will be enabled. Then you can click install and it'll download from online. But currently I have it installed, so I'm going to skip that. So the next thing we want to do is we want to scroll down to the LCD type. In this case, it's going to be reprap underscore discount underscore full underscore graphic underscore smart underscore controller. So we need to remove the comments. And that's all we need to do to set it up. So we're going to check to make sure that we have a port selected for the COM port to communicate with the MKS Gen version 1.4, and that we have the right chipset, which is the Mega 2560, which we're good there. So I'm going to press the upload button, which will then compile our changes and upload it to the MKS Gen L. And in a moment, I'll show you how to test it. Okay, we finally loaded the boot screen, so now we're going to test it by removing the USB so you can see what happens. And then we're going to plug it back in. And as you can see, it's powered up. Now it's going to show you the boot screen. And then finally, it's going to bring you to your Marlin screen and your status screen. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.